All right, what's up, everyone? Today I got this tutorial, and it's actually really slow, and it was created for beginners of Photoshop, so it might sound really slow to some people, but instead of deleting it, I thought I wanted to share it. So anyways, have fun with it. Okay, I want you to open up this image in Photoshop. This is our model that we're going to use. Because we have a white background, it will be easy to remove it. So, open up in Photoshop, select the magic wand tool. Make sure these settings are similar to this one. And let's select this white area. Now we have also a little bit of white here, so hold down shift and press on this area. So now we have all the white background selected. Now we have to create a mask of it. So select the rectangular tool, press the right mouse click and select inverse. So we select her instead of the background. Now go to masks and click add a mask. So all this white is now gone. Now let's create a background. So go to new adjustment layer, select gradient, and let's pick something like this. Just click on this little arrow here and let's pick something less colorful, so something blue on one side and a little bit of orange on the other side. Make sure it's not too bright or else it won't look good, so something like this. Maybe a little bit of darker. Now, once you got the two colors selected, press OK. And let's make sure we have one side here and the other side here. So I'm just gonna adjust the angle and bring it up to zero. Let's do the left side orange and the right side blue. Now just press OK and drag this file underneath the layer of the girl. All right, now we have this a little bit of white border around her. So to remove that, select the girl's layer, click on the mask of the layer, zoom in, grab a brush, go all the way up here and let's increase the hardness. So we have a hard edge and resize it a little bit. You can leave these at 100 for this. And make sure you select the black color. Black color is to remove it and white is to show it. So just go around the edge like that. To get rid of all that bad looking. Once you made it a little bit better, select the mask of it, click your right mouse and go to select a mask and select this one. Make sure you have plus here leave these settings as it is and just brush the edge. So we will remove that white border around it because it is ruining the image. So something like this is fine. We can drop the shift edge a little bit. Right, now press OK. And we still have this border, but we will just use the brush to remove this also. Okay, that is fine for now. This is our model. Now, we want to create some lighting. So to create lighting, we need to create shadows first. So to create shadows, I'm going to create a new adjustment layer on top of the layer of the model. So this is our model and go all the way down here. Select curves. Now you want to right mouse click on the curves layer and select create clipping mask. This way we will only affect the layer underneath it. So if we adjust this layer, it will not edit the background and all the other layers. So now click on this to adjust the curves. These are the highlights of the image. These are the midtones and these are the darker tones. So we want to make it darker, so we have to remove the highlights. So select the highlight and bring it down. Now it looks a little bit of gray with less contrast, so we need to increase the contrast. So we select the midtones and bring them a little bit down. Like that. So we have made our image darker. Now let's create another curve layer on top of it to make areas lighter. We are creating different curve layers so we can always adjust them one by one. So if we need to adjust the light, we just gonna adjust the curve layer of the lights. So create a new curve layer on top of it. Make sure you make a clipping mask again. And this time we're going to bring up the highlights. So select the highlight and just move it to the left. So now we have a nice contrast. All right, let's create some colors now to her face and body. So we have blue light coming from here and we have some orange light coming from this side, so we need to make this side of her a little bit of blue, this side of her a little bit of orange. So I'm gonna create a new layer on top of everything, then go to the color picker and click on the background of the blue area and bring this all the way up. So we have the light tint of this big black dark background. Now bring down the hardness to 0. Bring up the opacity and the flow. And click anywhere in the image to make a little dot. Then press Ctrl T to check if your image stays inside the original image. because if you make it like this, you press Ctrl T, it goes all the way to the border, and if you move this, you will see this white line. So that's not right. Make sure it's not too big, something like this. Press Ctrl T or Command T or Mac to make sure it's inside the image, even smaller, like this. So this is fine, and let's move this to the right side. Now press Ctrl T to resize it, hold down Alt to make it bigger, and move it around a little bit so we have this blue light coming from this side. Now you can duplicate the layer, so just drag the layer onto this, release it, and we have a duplicated version of it. Now change the blending mode to screen and make it a little bit smaller. So this is where the light comes from. This is the blue that's coming from the light. And now we have our light source here. Let's create a new layer on top of it to make some areas of her blue. So I'm gonna select blue. Bring this a little bit down so it's not too bright. And again, click anywhere on the image and hold down alt and make it bigger, and something like this. Press enter and change the blending mode to color. So we're using that layer to color up right side. Now let's put this in a folder. This is right side blue. Now let's do the same for the left side. Let's create the folder left side orange. So create a new layer, select the color picker, click on this orange background, bring these up, press OK, click anywhere, drag it to the edge, make it a little bit bigger, drag it to the edge, change the blending mode to screen, duplicate the layer, change the blending mode to normal, put it behind the screen layer and make it bigger. Maybe not too big. And create a new layer. Select the color picker. Select something less bright. Click again. Change the blending mode to color and make this big. And move it a little bit down. So it won't ruin her face. Like that. Maybe we can even stretch this out. So this is our layer where the most light comes from. Press Ctrl T, hold down Alt and Shift and stretch it like that. And do the same with the blue. Ctrl T, hold down Alt and Shift and stretch it like that. Right, so now we have these lights coming from the side of her. Okay, let's create some dodge and burn. So we use dodge to lighten up areas and burn to make areas darker. So let's start with dodge. Select the girls layer. This is our model layer. Go above to the curves. Click on a new layer. Click the right mouse, create clipping mask. Then go to edit, fill, select 50% gray, press OK, and change the blending mode to overlay. So this way we have a separate layer for our dodge and burn that you can always adjust if you want to make it lighter or do some other things with it. So let's start with the dodge tool. Select highlights, bring the exposure all the way up to 100, and this is where our light comes from, so she will need some reflection here because it's coming from here, probably also here. You can even make it bigger for the neck, so drop the exposure a little bit, make the brush bigger and like that. And make the brush smaller again to do a little bit of the edge on her. So we have that nice reflection from the light. Okay, that is good. Now let's do the other side. So it's probably some reflections here on the finger from the light. Just don't do it too much or else it won't look real. So this was before and this is now. You can even do her ear here. And same goes for this side. Just a little bit of reflection. Let's also do her hair a little bit, because this orange light is much more brighter than blue light. So let's do a little bit more on this side. Just make sure the brush isn't too big. And if you ever make a mistake, just make a mask. Select the brush, pick a black color and remove some areas. I think this looks fine for now. And if you feel it's too bright, you can just bring down the opacity a little bit. All right, because this yellow light is brighter, we have to do a little bit more here. So just a little brighter here. And if you drop the opacity, change it to midtones so it won't be too much. Before and after. And let's drop the opacity a little bit so it won't be too much. All right, now let's make this area a little bit more blue. So go to the right side blue map, create a new layer. And select the background blue. Select something like this. Just click anywhere and change the blending mode to overlay and make it big. And drop the opacity so it won't be too much. All right, that looks fine, maybe around 40%. Okay, let's do some burn now. So we have this dodge layer. We have the highlights. Let's also do the burn on this layer. And go to the burn tool. And start with highlights, then midtones, then shadows. So first highlights. Set exposure to 50. The key with the burn tool is to not do it too much, because if you do it too much, you will just ruin the image. So it doesn't need to be much, it's just a little bit of extra. You can compare this to when you hold the lighter to a piece of paper, and when you hold it too long, the paper is just burnt and ruined. If you do it a little bit, you will make it darker. So start with highlights, exposure at 50, and just gently make these areas in the back darker. Under her chin, because we have shadows under her chin, behind her hand here, maybe also here. Just these areas where we have some shadows, we can create more shadow to give more contrast to the image with what makes it look better at the end. So I think that is enough. It's just a little bit maybe here. And now select midtones, take 25%. So we take half of it and make the brush bigger. Maybe also here. Also here. Around her eyes, we have some shadows around the eyes. And last but not least, shadows, and bring it all the way down to 10. And make it bigger again. So this was before, and this is after all the shadows with the burn tool and the dodge tool. So that's a huge difference. It looks a lot better. Okay, let's make this side a little bit of darker, because we have a light coming a little bit behind her. So this area needs a little bit more darkness. So select the top map, make a new layer on top of it. Select the color and pick something dark blue, something like that. Press OK and pick a general brush. Bring down the hardness, bring up the opacity and flow, and make it big. And just make something like that. And change the blending mode to soft light and bring down the opacity. You can even use overlay or soft light. It's always one of those that usually works. I think soft light is fine here. And let's add some particles. So I got this image. We need to make it a little bit darker. So first press Command or Control L on your keyboard to bring up the levels. Then select the black picker and click somewhere on the black area to make it really black. Press OK. Now just drag this into our file. Create a smart object. So right mouse click, convert to smart object. So we won't ruin the quality of the particles, and press Ctrl or Command T. Then hold down Shift and rotate it like that. Hold down Alt and make it bigger. Something like that. Press Enter and change the blending mode to screen. So you have this nice flying particles around her, which gives that little extra to it. Now you want to make sure these particles are not in her face. So let's make a mask. Select the brush. Make sure you have a black brush. Make sure these are 100. Make it a little bit smaller. And get rid of these particles in the face. Maybe you leave some around here flying. Just to make sure you won't ruin her face. So something like this is fine. You can even just play around with it and see what you like best. So I think this is fine. Let's do some final adjustments. I think the background can be a little bit darker, so her face will be more in the center of attention. So I'll select the background layer. Click adjustment layer and make curves. And bring the highlights a little bit down. So we have a little bit darker background. This was before, this is after. And let's do some color balance. So select the top layer, create a new adjustment layer and go to color balance. Let's make it a little bit warmer. So this is before, this after, a little bit more color. And last but not least, another layer and some curves on top to make it lighter. All right, that is it for this one. This is fine to me. You can always play around with the settings and edit stuff you want when you're done. So I'm happy with this one. I hope you learned something.